Hi, today we will learn the letter D in Spanish.
La letra D, letter D.
So we will see some words that begin with letter D, okay?
We will see some masculine given names, feminine given names,
names of animals, names of fruits,
adjectives, adverbs that begin with D,
false friends, some regular and irregular verbs. And in the next class, I will show you how to conjugate those irregular verbs that we will see today, okay? So I have chosen some important verbs in Spanish, okay? So of the huge list of verbs, we will see some of the most used verbs in Spanish, okay? So let's begin. We have nombres propios masculinos. Nombres propios masculinos are masculine given names, okay? Remember, in Spanish, first we have always the noun, later comes the description, okay? And the more related the adjective is to the noun, the nearer it goes to the noun. So given names, the word given comes first, right? And later comes masculine, right? Because masculine is an adjective that relates to both the word names and given, okay? Given names as an idea. So we have Daniel, Darío, David. Daniel, Darío, David. Those three are very common Spanish names, okay? For nombres propios femeninos que comienzan con la letra D. Feminine given names that begin with the letter D. Tenemos Daniela, Diana, Débora. Daniela, Diana, Débora. Estos tres nombres comienzan con la letra D. These three names begin with the letter D. Ahora vamos a ver nombres de animales que comienzan con la letra D. Okay? Now we will see names of animals that begin with the letter D. We have, tenemos el dragón. Dragón es un animal ficticio, pero tenemos el dragón de Komodo en Australia. Dragon is a fictitious animal, right? But we have the Komodo dragon in Australia. Tenemos el delfín, we have the dolphin. Y tenemos el dinosaurio, que ya está extinto. And we have the dinosaur that now is already extinct. Ahora vamos a ver nombres de frutas que comienzan con la letra D. Now we will see names of fruits that begin with the letter D. Frutas y verduras, fruits and vegetables, aunque vamos a ver frutas solo. Tenemos el damasco, the apricot. Tenemos el dátil, the date. Y tenemos el durazno, the peach. Ahora veremos adjetivos que comienzan con la letra D. Now we will see some adjectives that begin with the letter D. Dañino. Dañino means harmful. Dañino. Fíjense la ñ, esta letra. Ñ, ñ, ñ. Dañino. For harmful. Tenemos duro. Duro significa hard. Duro means hard. Both in the literal sense and in the figurative sense, okay? Duro. So, duro puede ser un objeto que es duro, ¿sí? Y puede ser una actitud dura hacia alguien. So, duro or hard can be related to something that is hard or also to an attitude or somebody's behavior towards somebody else, okay? Y tenemos débil. Débil means weak, right? Somebody weak without strength. Ahora veremos algunos adverbios. Adverbios or adverbs. Tenemos débilmente. Débilmente, weakly, right? With no strength. Tenemos decididamente, decidedly, right? Or surely, decididamente. With decision, right? With determination, actually. And we have duramente. Duramente, hardly, or harshly, okay?
Actually, duramente is the adverb that comes from the verb dura, duro or dura, which means hard, but it means actually, when it's an adverb like here, it means harshly, okay? Harshly.
Ahora veremos algunos false friends o falsos amigos o falsos cognatos.
Now we will see some false friends with the letter D, right? Or false cognates.
Tenemos tres palabras. No, cuatro palabras. Cuatro palabras.
Four words.
Decepción. Decepción. Decepción does not mean deception.
The word for deception in Spanish is engaño.
Right? Decepción means disappointment.
We have the word delito. Delito has nothing to do with delight. Delito means crime, okay? Delito is a crime.
The Spanish word disgusto, disgusto does not mean disgust.
The Spanish word for disgust is desagrado, right? Or asco, or repulsión.
Disgusto means annoyance, annoyance, okay?
I heard a bad news and now I have disgusto, or I am disgustado, right?
Disgusto is annoyance. And the word despertar, which means to wake up.
And it does not mean, it's not desperate, okay? The word for desperate is desesperado in Spanish.
Despertar is to wake up. So, decepción, disappointment. Delito means crime.
Actually, the Spanish word for delight is deleite, right?
But delito is crime. Disgusto is annoyance and despertar is to wake up.
Now, ahora vamos a ver algunos verbos regulares y verbos irregulares. Now we will see some regular verbs and some irregular verbs. Always beginning with the letter D, right? Siempre comenzando con la letra D.
Vamos a ver, tenemos el verbo dañar.
El verbo dañar.
The verb dañar means to harm or to spoil, right?
Dañar can be towards somebody or towards an object, right? I can tell somebody, no me hagas daño, do not harm me, right? Or I can also say, no dañes esto, don't spoil this, okay?
The verb dejar, dejar.
Dejar means to leave something, right? Not to leave when you go away, to leave something. I will leave this here.
Voy a dejar esto aquí. Voy a dejar esto aquí. I will leave this here.
And also, dejar means to let, right? For example, déjame ir. Let me go, right? No lo dejes ir. Don't let him go, right?
So, dejar can mean to leave or to let, right? And we have the verb depender.
Depender. The verb depender means to depend. To depend on is depender de.
We add the preposition de, right? And that means to depend on.
We can say, for example, esto depende de aquello. This depends on that, right? Or I can say, depende, or todo depende. It all depends, right? With three dots, okay?
So, these verbs are regular verbs, so they follow the regular rule for conjugating them, right?
Remember, we dedicated the 22 videos, right? From lesson 130 to lesson 151, where I showed you in some PowerPoint video lessons how all the regular verbs of the three classifications, ar, er, and ir, are conjugated in Spanish in all the 22 different verbal tenses, okay?
So, if you studied that, you'll be able how to conjugate any of these three verbs, okay?